Hello, friends. Congratulations. This is a summary of urgency of the positive and far-reaching change in the situation. Opinion article. Turning the tables. The omelette has been turned upside down. Vote certification is cancelled. Didn't they say there was no evidence? Election results blocked. President's legal victory begins. Thanksgiving produces a miracle. Election fraud was carried out by many means. Votes annulled in Pennsylvania, Georgia, and Nevada. China was involved in manipulating the results. The media is silent after lying. Sidney Powell frees the Kraken with lawsuits in Michigan and Georgia. It's confirmed that authentic ballots did have a watermark, as it was said. Let's start. We didn't have to wait until mid-December. Thanksgiving has worked the miracle. Didn't they say there was no proof? Right now, the media are silent after having proclaimed a president without waiting for the courts, and the cheats are hiding and scared. The electoral turnaround has changed in the opposite direction from what it was before. The judges have annulled the certification of votes in Pennsylvania, Georgia, and Nevada because of evidence of fraud, so that the Democratic candidate is no longer the president-elect that the media had proclaimed him to be, according to Elena Berberana in Libertad Digital. According to Rafa Pal, the lawsuit for electoral fraud in Georgia shows that the Chinese government participated in the manipulation of the results and that the ballots did have a special watermark. It is impossible not to highlight the relevance, implications, and importance of what is happening in the United States right now. It affects every man, woman, and child on the planet. Everyone now and for generations to come. This is a crucial moment in the history of the Earth. The Pennsylvania judge, Patricia McCulloch, has given the go-ahead to prevent what, until now, was more than just alleged electoral fraud. And she has done so after having read the lawsuit by the president's lawyer, taking the decision to order the annulment of the electoral votes. The judge found solid evidence and indications of electoral fraud in Pennsylvania in the lawsuit, which allowed Rudy Giuliani to appear at a public hearing broadcast live on Wednesday night. During his presentation, the president's counsel began to clarify that Biden outperformed Trump by 81,000 votes in Pennsylvania, but the legal team has found that there are between 800,000 and 1.2 million illegal votes. For Giuliani, the election have started again, because the result is not decided. We discovered more than 8,000 votes from dead people. There were also thousands of votes from people who, when they went to vote, found that they had already voted for them. In addition, there are hundreds of thousands of votes that the Republican observers could not verify, he added. But not only that, lawyer Lynn Wood has managed to get the emergency motion for expedited review of the lawsuit accepted, which challenges the validity of the election procedure in Georgia. Also in Georgia and Michigan, attorney Sidney Powell has intervened, releasing the Kraken, who has filed lawsuits in those states. And then there is Nevada, where the president's legal team has managed to get a judge to set dates for a hearing and consequently has blocked the certificate of electoral votes that went to the Democratic candidate. Sidney Powell has also filed a lawsuit in Georgia and one in Michigan. As she says, she has freed the Kraken. Both litigants claim to have strong evidence that will lead to the annulment of the electoral votes for the old man. "We have won a landslide victory for the president in Georgia," Utz celebrated. "We, the people, will not allow him to be robbed," the prestigious lawyer said. In Georgia, Powell claims that in a 104-page complaint filed in the district court in Atlanta that the purpose of the plan was to illegally and fraudulently manipulate the vote count. The lawsuit includes among the defendants Governor Brian Kemp, Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger, members of the Republican Party and several state election board members. This lawsuit was brought on behalf of several citizens of the state of Georgia. In Michigan, Powell filed a 75-page complaint seeking to set aside the election results and alleging that hundreds of thousands of illegal, ineligible, duplicate, or purely fictitious ballots were qualified by massive voter fraud. The efforts of the Republican has also borne fruit in Nevada. Another point of the Republican is this state. A judge has already decreed that dates for hearing be set and has therefore blocked the certificate of electoral votes that went to the Democratic candidate. Just as they are trying to do in Pennsylvania, the president's legal team can turn the results around in Nevada. And that's all for now, and congratulations to everybody.